and assure you that desire to see Pakistan become an economic power once again still burns in me. And I'm just reminded of the 60s when we were the fourth largest economy in Asia, when our economy was twice the size of South Korea, twice the size of Saudi Arabia, and twice the size of Thailand in dollar terms. Now this is West Pakistan. I'm not even talking about the combined economies of West and East. And you all know, probably you're more knowledgeable than I am, that we also contributed development of Germany at one time. Maybe we gave few million dollars, but we did. And when our president would land in Washington, then the president of the United States would come and receive him in a motorcade. And now, here we are in the 23rd IMF program. Every 4 or 5 years, we have to go back, and we are basically yearning for a few dollars. My father was one of those people who worked with Qaid-e-Azam as a student leader and was part of the Punjab Muslim Student Federation. He died when he was the chairman of Pakistan Workers' Trust and Nazriya Pakistan. So his desire for a better Pakistan was always with him and runs in the family. That is why I just left a very lucrative job with Citibank and came here to just fix Habib Bank, which was not easy. I think it was one of the most challenging jobs I just undertook. But then there was passion and faith that if you believe in Almighty and you just basically have a passion and you have honesty of purpose, you can achieve anything. So God has been kind. Now I have got this assignment, which obviously I owe it to God Almighty and also to Imran Khan, who is a personal friend of mine, and he has been trying for the last 2 years to get me in. But I also had a problem that for no rhyme or reason I was implicated in a case in what they call rental power, which I stopped, and surprise, surprise, my name is also there. But I said, unless I'm not cleared of those, I'm not going to join any government. And once I was cleared, so I did. So this is what has happened. Let me tell you what will happen, inshallah, when I'm here as the finance minister. You saw the glimpse of that, you know, in the budget. That budget, I tried to consult everybody in the business community, tried to accommodate as much as I could, remaining within the framework of IMF. At times I just flouted some of those areas as well. I mean, you know that IMF is not happy on a couple of things, but I still try to move forward. So why am I here? My first visit to Karachi officially, the first stop obviously after meeting the State Bank, I'm here. I'm meeting you guys. I'm not meeting FBCCI. I'm meeting Overseas Chamber and obviously Pakistan Business Council, which is basically a group of very important, you know, a kind of corporates. Why? Because I believe that, you know, we need you more than that you need us. We have to make sure that you are happy. So here I want to give you a pledge that my doors for you will always be open. I'll officially I will come over here every quarter with people from the FBR, even SCCP. He was on vacation. It was short notice. Next time around, we will plan it in a manner that everybody, all stakeholders, you know, from our side, they are here to answer your questions, to resolve your issues here and now and here, and, you know, because I don't believe in, you know, committees. I don't believe in, you know, postponing decisions which we can be taken, you know, immediately. And I just want you to know that no matter what the issues are, they are issues. They have to be resolved. We may not be able to resolve them right now because we have constraints of IMF, and, you know, we may not have some fiscal space here and there. But we will take a decision, and we will resolve them over a period of time. But directionally, we'll give a signal. If there's a taxes, let's say turnover tax. I think there was 1.5% of turnover tax. We just reduced it to 1.25, saying that it will go away in the next 2-3 years. That kind of signal everybody knows, because when you are just investing in any country, any venture, you basically think long term. These are not 6-month cycles or, you know, 12-month cycles. So when you directionally know this is going to happen, you obviously you are at ease. You know that this is going to happen. And then the credibility of the government. So whatever I say, and if I just basically renege, you know, 6 months later, that's not going to help. Okay. So you know that, you know, this time around I didn't have to go and just get it passed, you know, through the ECC and the cabinet, that, you know, to this textile and other exporting groups, that we give them gas at $6.50 and give electricity at 9 cents. I didn't have to do it, but I had promised on the floor of the parliament that we'll do it for this next year. So I thought it necessary that we will basically reiterate it through the ECC and cabinet decision, put their minds at peace. Let me tell you what, they had not really calculated the whole thing properly in the budget. The cost to me is going to be twice as much as we thought. So my colleague says, Shauke Saab, you know how it is, additionality in the cost. I said, that doesn't matter. If we have given a word, we'll stand by that. We'll make sure that this is not misused, because that's the understanding. Otherwise, even if it costs me 3 times, we'll stand by. So that's the way I think, because I'm a private sector person. I understand that people, when they invest under a kind of certain policy guidelines of the government. So same thing with the overseas chamber. I know that, you know, you guys brought in a lot of, you know, capital. And capital has no religion, no geographic boundaries. It will go where it is safe, where it makes money. Otherwise, it will flow out. And we have seen a lot of capital flowing out of, you know, Pakistan, from the banking sector, pharmaceuticals, and some others. And maybe a few of you are still thinking of doing the same thing. But I can assure you, have faith in us. Have faith in, you know, this man sitting over here, and we will make sure that we'll keep you happy, because that's my task, keep you happy. Because if you are happy, then you'll make your head offices happy, and they will then invest more. So it's my interest that I keep you happy. Okay, so this is my pledge to you, and don't you think that there is any decision for me is difficult. No, I just believe making you happy is the primary objective. I understand that there are issues, some of those issues which we can, I can discuss over here, later on, and those issues are burning issues. We will discuss them today. And some of those issues, one is obviously a turnover tax issue, you know, because, and especially OMCs, they have a, you know, turnover tax issues. Their inter corporate dividend, you know, issue, which basically was exempted and then put back last year, and it's basically, it's frankly an IMF conditionality. And I don't believe in that, by the way. I just don't believe in that, you know, it's a regressive tax, you know. Why the hell can't companies, you know, offset, you know, tax if they are in one group? We'll also be looking at this ruling on WWF, you know, a kind of liability which cannot be adjusted to get tax refunds. You know, I've just told the chairman of FBR to talk to us. There is this question. People are just get apprehensive. We talked about point of sale, and those machines are not. No, I think you should rest assured that we are single-minded. What is happening today is that to achieve the integration, the software which had to be harmonized, there are a lot of other capacity building to be done within FBR, both on, you know, a kind of computing, CPU. And disk capacity, and then connectivity. So that those things had to be done. Is being done. We believe that we will hit, you know, 70,000 to 80,000 to 100,000, you know, retailers this year, and move on. So don't worry about that. I also believe that there are concerns about a few other things. Global registration, and I think this is the first time we have done that. I think there are apprehensions, so we'll look into that. You know, can we just, and this also I'm sure has come from IMF. There are certain things about deposit of unpaid dividends and government treasury and et cetera, et cetera. We'll take a look at it. I've been just given this, that these are concerns. You also have a problem of attendance on AGM, you know, through video links. Absolutely, why not? So, Chairman, SCCP is not here, otherwise we could have taken a decision right now. But we will be taking a decision. So, effectively what I'm saying is that the issues you will raise today and issues you will raise in days to come will be accorded the highest priority as far as I'm concerned. So let me talk about, you know, where we are in the economy a little bit before we just open for the questions. What we did, you know, last week with the Prime Minister, this is after, you know, 1.5-2 months of, you know, exercise. My EAC, which is the Economic Advisory Council, some of you are members of that. They participated, and we prepared 14 plans, short, medium, long-term plans of areas like, you know, how to improve the revenues of the government, the power sector, the housing, agriculture, industry, exports, CPAC, IT. There are 14 areas. And after 1972, the planning in Pakistan economy was abandoned because we dismantled the Pakistan the Planning Commission. Now become basically a project approving and implementation, you know, division. And because we did not have, you know, short, medium, long-term plans, we obviously, you know, we had, you know, zigzagging of, you know, policies. So this time around, I just involved the government, which means the minister and their deputy minister or so, plus private sector people, so stakeholders. And most of the presentations were actually made by the private sector people to the Prime Minister. So those plans are there, and we will share them. We'll give you those plans, you know, this thick, you know. But what are we going to do? Would they go back, you know, and be sitting on shelves? No. They will be living documents. Every month, the same teams will basically be stand in front of the Prime Minister and say, this is what we promised on a short-term basis, medium and long. This is what we have achieved, and this is what we have not achieved. So this is a kind of review process. You do it all the time in your businesses. Government was not doing it. This was supposed to be done by the Planning Commission. But as Planning Commission had become redundant, so nobody was doing it. So it was a piecemeal thing, you know, by individual ministries. Now this will now come under the finance. I'm going to have a cell, which I think, you know, you probably know a lady sitting here, Aisha Aziz, who basically will be working with me in the Ministry of Finance, and she is going to coordinate this, but it will be done professionally. People, you know, who are professional, you know, analysts, you know, will take them from PIDE. You know that PIDE is a government institution run by Nadeemul Haq, and they'll help us to organize these meetings with the Prime Minister for each one of those ministries. So there will be some, you know, there's a method to the madness. And after God knows how many years, after 1972, okay, that's one, that's a good thing. Our revenues are growing well. As I mentioned that, you know, I think in the budget speech and later on, that there are two or three things which we are doing. One is that we are trying to expand the tax base, what we call broadening, and where we are using technology. Now we got data from various sources, from the electricity bills, telephone bills, deposit data, travel, etc. So we have now, you know, the profile of the customers, unregistered voters also by name. There are 7.2 million, you know, names with the FBR and 15 million names with NADRA. They're not talking to each other. And through artificial intelligence and comparing it with the behavior with the registered, you know, kind of taxpayers, we have just gone to the unregistered, and we can, accuracy of 80% to 90%, we can tell people what your income is, level is, and how much tax you should pay. 80% to 90%. Now, who's going to knock the door? Would the FBR going to knock the door? So what I promised in the budget was the harassment of FBR, and this is not casting any aspersions on people who are sitting over here. But generally, there is a perception that there is harassment over there, that, you know, they issue notices and, you know, they make life miserable. So there will be universal self-assessment, and there will be third-party audits. Only a fraction, maybe 2% or 3%, or whatever the FBR says, risk-based, that this guy has not declared, you know, majority of the income, it'll be given to a third party, you know, which means from ICAP we'll take, you know, maybe 50-100, you know, people, and only then they will, you know, just interface with the taxpayer, which means FBR is out, all told. Similar thing for broadening, there will be a knock. A knock is going to be maybe a text message which comes and says, Mr. Tareen, this is what you know. You, by the way, are not a taxpayer, registered taxpayer. This is what your income is. This is the tax you have to pay. Please deposit the tax. It'll be in your interest to deposit the tax. Maybe another reminder. And 2-3 reminders if the guy does not pay. Maybe there's another third party person can call and say, you know, you don't do it. And then I have law. The law is I'm going to arrest them. If they're too smart, and if we have basically done all these things to reduce harassment and they're still not paying, we have evidence, then we'll basically pick up a few people. So that's, you know, I'm very clear that, you know, this And I was, when I met the German, you know, economic minister, you know, several years ago, and she said, you know, in our country, what we say, there's no representation without taxation. If you're not a taxpayer, you have to pay taxes, then you have no bloody right to be a citizen of our country. So we take all actions. So, you know, I am being very soft, you know. I'm not being as harsh as they are. But it's about time that people who are not paying taxes, they start paying taxes, because people like you and me, we suffer. Because we pay taxes and, you know, the country actually doesn't progress. So no harassment, but a way, very polite way of reaching those, that's one, that's broadening. On the retail side, 18 trillion rupees of, you know, retail sales, we capture only 3.5 trillion. And we only collect 150 billion from the retailers. Okay. So this has to change. So what we are going to do is connect their, you know, POSs. We are going to, I'm going to pay for new POS machines. I'm going to take them up to half a million in the next couple of years. And they will be linked. And now how are we going to implement that? By giving prizes. We'll start.
گفتگو آپ نے ملاحظہ کی شامل کریں گے نیوز اپڈیٹس.